Today we will discuss what is retention. It is also called hydraulic retention time, residence time, or detention time. Retention is average length of time that a substance remains in a reactor or a digester. So what is a substance here? Substance can be water, it can be wastewater, it can be paddy straw, cattle dung. Hydraulic retention time, it is used when we are dealing with liquid. So what is a reactor or a digester? It's a vessel or a chamber or tank in which biological and chemical reactions. We'll study hydraulic retention time for three types of reactor. One is batch type of reactor, second is semi-continuous reactor, and third is continuous reactor. What is a batch? Batch is the quantity produced in one operation. So let me give you an example. Suppose for a four-year degree course, you join a college in year 2020 along with 100 other students. Then you are likely to complete your degree in 2024 along with those students, and entire batch will go out in year 2024. So similar is the concept of a batch reactor. Let's say you fill the reactor on day one with water or wastewater, and you empty this reactor after keeping it for some days. Then the time duration between these two activities, that is feeding and emptying the digester, is known as retention time. The retention time is 30 days for this reactor. We just keep the material for 30 days, and on 31st day we will empty this reactor, and again we can fill this reactor. So retention time for this type of reactor is 30 days if you keep it for 30 days. Now let us see the second type of reactor, that is semi-continuous reactor. Assume reactor has a volume of 20 liters. Consider a bottle having capacity of 1 liter. We will use this bottle to deliver 1 liter of water in the reactor. Let's add 1 liter of water each day. Guess in how many days it will fill the reactor? If your guess is 20 days, you are right. Let's quickly add all the water. 20 liter of reactor, and we are adding 1 liter of water per day. So it will take 20 days to fill the reactor. On 21st day, if you put more water, the water will spill out from this reactor. So this reactor has 20 days retention time. Formula for retention time for semi-continuous type of reactor is reactor volume divided by daily loading rate. So reactor volume in this case is 20 liters, and loading rate or inflow rate is 1 liter per day. So retention time is 20 days. Now this reactor also gives you the idea of short circuiting. So what is short circuiting? The short circuiting in retention time means the water which is added on day one in the reactor should be going out of the reactor after the end of retention time. However, this is not happening in the reactor we have considered. So water which we are adding on 21st day is also going out on that day itself. So let's see a new type of digester whose shape is closer to the actual reactor. This digester has an inlet pipe for inflow into the digester. It also has an outlet pipe for outflow from the digester. We will close this digester with a lid, and again we will put 1 liter of water per day in this reactor. Once this reactor is filled till outlet pipe, we will see that the water will flow from the outlet pipe. The water which was added on day one is at the top, and the water which was added on last day is still at the bottom. So this solves the problem of short circuiting. Guess what is the retention time for this reactor? We must find inflow rate and the volume of water up till the height H, which is shown here. Assume reactor volume is 15 liters up to height H, then the retention time will be 15 liters divided by 1 liter per day, which will give retention time equal to 15 days. For continuous type of reactor, the concept is same as semi-continuous reactor. Let us say we are adding 1 liter of water per minute and reactor volume is again 15 liters. So the retention time in this case will be 15 minutes only. So we have found out retention time for batch reactor, and it is accurately defined for batch type of reactors. And for continuous and semi-continuous reactor, retention time is volume of the digester divided by daily inflow rate. Further, we can also discuss on what parameters retention time depends. It depends upon process temperature. It also depends upon types of substrate used and pre-processing of substrates. This we will discuss later.